Even though right now my stock portfolio looks like this, I started very small. I started by purchasing just one stock of Core MSCI World back in January 20th, 2020. And purchasing that one stock built a lot of confidence inside me because I saw that like when you put the money inside, when you hit buy on the app, it doesn't magically just disappear somewhere. You can always sell the stock and you can get the money back. Now, in the starting, I wasn't that crazy about the stock market, so I just wanted to invest passively. I wanted to set aside a set amount of money every single month that I could invest in the stock market and not having to look at the Yahoo Finance or like, you know, the stock market charts and everything every single day when I wake up in the morning. Easy way to do that is by investing in ETFs. Think of ETFs as a collection of different kind of stocks. When you buy one stock of that ETF, you buy a percentage of all of the underlying stocks which are included in that ETF. Sounds complicated? Don't worry about it. I'm going to teach you in this video step by step how you can start investing in ETFs by using the Scalable Capital app. Think about 1000 different houses. And you have the option of buying either one of these 1000 different houses, but you do not know in which house the tenant would be good, which tenant is going to pay the money in time, and which house is going to be appreciating and which house is going to be depreciating and all of these things. So instead of buying one house, you try to get the percentage of every single one of those houses so that you have this risk mitigation there. In case one house goes wrong, completely screws up, there are also like another 999 houses which are going to make up for that. Same is the concept of ETF. Now, before we head into the investing part, an important disclaimer: this is all my personal opinion. Do your own due diligence, do your own research, and then start investing. Now I'm going to take you to the screen and I'm going to show you some charts. They will look a bit complicated, but don't worry about it. I have an easy way to explain them. Now, when you're thinking about investing in an ETF, you can always take a look at the PDF first, which is provided by the people who are offering that fund. So here, Vanguard S&P 500, we can go down and take a look at what exactly, you know, what kind of companies are they actually investing in. So first they show what kind of sectors they're investing in. IT is 28%, 14% is health and so on. Where are they investing? It is USA, 100%. And then you can also take a look at what kind of companies they're investing in. So Apple is 6.7%, Microsoft is 5.7%, Amazon 4.8%. So top 10 here, you can always see. And these top 10 are making around 30% of this entire portfolio, in which you will be investing by just buying one stock of, let's say, Vanguard S&P 500. And then you can take a look at the total expense ratio, which is the 0.07% here. This is the fee that Vanguard charges for managing this fund. So for example, if you're investing 1,000 euros inside, 70 cents will be the cost of, like, you know, keeping that fund every single year, which is very, very cheap if you compare it to mutual funds and stuff. And afterwards, you want to take a look at yield. So how much does it grow or how much does it go down? Now, let me show you another index, MSCI World Index. So here, it is very different. So instead of just investing in USA, it invests in 23 different developed markets with 1,607 different companies. Then afterwards, you have, for example, the 5-year yield here, it's 11.10%. And when you take a look at Vanguard, you have around, it was here, right? So here you have like around 13.72%. So this is how you can start comparing. Like, I personally like preferred Core MSCI World mainly because it is distributed along different kind of countries. And this is how the country distribution looks like. United States is 66%, Japan is 7.86%, United Kingdom 4%, France 3%, Switzerland 3%, and others are 15.19%. Information technology is also having a heavy sector here, around like 22%. And the top 10 constituents are Apple 4.46, Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, and so on. So the top 10 here makes a lot less. They only make 17.33% of the entire index in comparison to Vanguard, where the top 10 make around 29.1%. Now, this could have its positives or negatives. For example, the Vanguard S&P 500, it is just focused in USA. So in case the market only in USA screws up, that means your entire portfolio is going down. But if you're investing in the Core MSCI World, you are diversified across a lot of different countries, which is very nice. And as soon as there is some kind of problems happening, they can also then adjust the index better. So this, of course, like, makes me sleep better at night, thinking that like my investment is happening in the entire global market and not just in one single country. But of course, it has its own negatives too. When you take a look at the charts, you generally see the S&P 500 is most of the times outperforming the Core MSCI World. mainly because it is focused on the best of the best companies in one single country. And Core MSCI World is taking into account all of the major companies in more developed nations. The Vanguard S&P 500, of course, it has better yields many times, mainly because it is investing in one single country. So in 5 years, it is giving you a positive yield of 81.61%. whereas the Core MSCI World is only giving 56.22%. So this is again your personal choice. You can see what you want to do here. Once you decide that, all right, I don't want to take too much risk, I want to go with Core MSCI World because I want to invest in 23 developed markets, you can copy the ISIN number. So ISIN number is here, and then afterwards you can go into the app. Now I already own around 211 shares of this, and then setting up a savings plan is very simple. What a savings plan is that every single month, a set amount of money gets invested in a particular ETF that you're choosing. And with Scalable Capital, you're doing it completely for free for the first ETF without any cost, even on the free plan, which is very interesting. So here you just directly tip at Jetzt einrichten. And I'm not going to invest 500 euros. I will start by investing 25 euros per month. So Sparplan überprüfen. And then you can read all of the details here. All right, iShares, Core MSCI World. And Häufigkeit is monatlich. So, you know, every single month. And Ausführung, Monatsanfang. So every single month, in the starting of the month, it is going to execute. So here, Sparplan einrichten. And then I can click on Fertig. The only thing that you have to remember is that when the savings plan is happening, you transfer enough money from your Girokonto to the Scalable Capital account so that when the date comes, it executes without any kind of problems whatsoever. Another interesting thing is you can cancel the Sparplan anytime you want. So I can also like quickly show you so that you don't feel like, yeah, I just like, you know, turned it on, but I cannot remove it. So when you want to cancel it, you just directly click on this 25 euros per month, whatever like the amount must be. You click on Bearbeiten, and then afterwards you can do zero, and then you can deactivate. And it is as simple as that. That means you are not bound. And this is the thing that I love the most about like investing in the stock market, that I have the complete control over my own finances. I don't have to do Bausparvertrag or something. When I actually need the money, they charge us somewhere around like 10% of just like cancellation fee, which I found really horrid. Like, this is the reason I would never ever in my life go for a Bausparvertrag ever again. Alina and I, we had very horrid experiences with that, so I will be like, you know, talking about that in a separate video. But so far, I think like investing in ETFs and then taking the money out when you actually need it, it's nice. But I would also say that only invest the money that you do not need to take out in the shorter run, because only this way you will be able to get that compound interest, which really multiplies your money every single year that you're leaving it inside the stock market. Just to give you an idea how big the difference can be when you start investing right now, or like maybe in a few months or years, I'll just quickly show you the compound interest calculator. So here, let's say the regular deposits are around 25 euros a month. So don't worry about the currency. We are just taking a look at the numbers. Compounding frequency is annual. Let's say you are right now 22 years old and we are going to invest it till 67 years. So you have 45 years of investing time and you have around 7% of annual interest rate. That means just on the money that you have invested, so $13,500 is what you've invested, you're getting $72,000. So like almost like six times the money back just in compound interest. Let's say we increase it, we do it to $100 a month, you're getting 288,000 euros just in interest. And if you would, let's say, do it a bit less, not for 45 years, let's say you just did it for 40 years or something, you're missing on almost 100,000 euros purely in compound interest. And this is what I find absolutely crazy. That's why start investing as soon as possible and let your money work for you. I also started with small amounts and it is completely fine. All that matters is that you're at least starting when most of the other people do not care about it at all. All right, so that was pretty much it. Sign up for the Scalable Capital Depot and get the 25 euro sign up bonus till 31st October. I don't know if you guys haven't done it yet. I told you last time, like, already do it so that you can start the savings plan together. If you haven't done it, you still have another chance. Like, it is happening till 31st October. Go ahead, use the link in the description, fill out the application form, get your posted and done, transfer the money and set up the savings plan. It is this simple. Thank you so much for watching again. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.